The toughest thing to do in sports is the second half of a game on the second night of a back-to-back. And you saw that today from the Toronto Raptors as they dropped this one 103-95 to the Dallas Mavericks and fall to 1-2 on the season. Pretty good first half. The defensive intensity was there. Your offense was flowing for the most part. But in that second half, they looked tired. They looked exhausted. And they tried to fight through it, tried to grind through it. Maybe they tried to have a little bit of a comeback late, but it was too little too late as they fall by 8, 103-95 to the Dallas Mavericks. Let's break down this game, right? First quarter, like I said, the offense wasn't quite cooking per se, but they scored 25. They only allowed 18. The defensive intensity was there. They're up 7 after one quarter of play. In that second quarter, you know, again, you have it. Yeah, had an 8-point lead. You had a double-digit lead at one point. You're feeling pretty good. The Mavericks cut it back to 6 at halftime. They win that quarter 27-26, but you're still up by 6 at halftime. But now comes that dreaded second half. How are you going to come out of the gate, right? We saw yesterday when the Raptors came out of the break in the second half, they came out guns a-blazing. Now, this is a little different, though. You're on the second night of the back-to-back. It's going to be difficult. And you saw that today. In that third quarter, the Raptors had a really tough time in most aspects. They allowed 29. They only scored 21. Offensively, the ball just wasn't moving enough. And when it was getting turned over, thrown out of bounds. Communication was a little bit off. They looked a little out of sorts there in that third quarter. They lose the third quarter 29-21, as I mentioned, minus 8 in the quarter. But you're only down by 2 heading into the fourth quarter. Do you have that last little bit of push? Fight, that extra juice in you at the end of the game to pull this one out? They obviously did not have that in them, unfortunately, as they fall in the fourth quarter, 29-23. They weren't down like, 14 late. They get it back to 8, but that's all she wrote. And it's a tough one. It is what it is. But you know what, Raptor fans, we've talked about it, you know, throughout the course of the season so far. This season, we don't know what to expect. The expectations aren't really there, but you know what you're going to get from this team every single night. You're going to get damn good defense, and you're going to get fight, fight, fight. And you saw that tonight. Even when they weren't playing well, they were still trying to grind through it, and it's unfortunate they couldn't pull it out, right? A lot of great statistical performances, though, today. A lot of guys that had tough starts really getting into the groove, all right? Let's start with Precious Achiuwa. He had a great game. He had back-to-back double-doubles for young Precious. 10 points, 12 rebounds, 3 dimes in the game for Precious, 4 of 9 from the field. He did a great job. Considering he was facing Kristaps Porzingis, a mammoth size of a human. I mean, considering that, you know, against Precious, he's got much more size than him. So that's a very tough matchup for him. And yeah, he had a little bit of a tough time at times, but again, gets the double-double, shoots 4 of 9. I'll take that from Precious Achiuwa any day of the week, all right? OG Anunoby, we talked about it in the first two games. You know, the shot wasn't there. He seemed like he was forcing it a little too much. But today, let the offense come to him early on, and he started knocking down shots, and he was buzzing early on. I mean, in the first quarter, he knocked down 5 shots. Like, he was absolutely buzzing early on. Ends of the game, 24 points, 4 boards, no dimes. 9 of 15 from the field, 5 of 9 from three-point range. He had 2 steals and 2 blocks. So not only is he giving you effective shooting, he's giving you the defense. And we all know that's what we're going to get from OG. That's a fantastic game from the young OG. He was great. When the other guys needed the support, he was there, and he got them out and running early on. All right, Fred VanVleet, another guy that's had a struggle for the first couple of games, shooting the basketball at least, but a much better performance today. 20 points, 5 boards, 5 dimes. 8 of 17 shooting was, 2 of 5 from the free throw line. Very weird that he was 2 of 5 from the line. That's not like Fred VanVleet. Was 2 of 6, where are we here? 2 of 5, no, is that from 3? No, 2 of 9, I believe it is, from 3-point range. So, tough night shooting for Fred VanVleet from beyond the arc. And from the free throw line, but from the field, he did a pretty good job. The mid-range game was working for Fred today. A lot of times he came off, he got into the paint, kind of the step back was really working today for Freddie V. And he felt it early on, and he just kept going to it. And that's what you love to see from the vet guard. I mean, I want to put it in quotes because he's 27, but I mean, on this team, he's basically a vet. And Gary Trent Jr., unfortunately, you know, after the great game he put up yesterday in Boston, struggled shooting the basketball today. 12 points, 4 boards, no dimes, 3 of 14 from the field. Not a good one there. Was 2 of 6 from 3-point range. We knocked down a couple trays, but 3 of 14 from the field. Tough night in the offense. I didn't even think he was really forcing his shots today. It's just they played some really solid defense against him, and he just it just wasn't going in for him. Yeah, he did have a steal and a block in the game, so he did give it to you on the defensive end, but unfortunately didn't get quite enough offense from Gary Trent Jr. today. Scotty Barnes, though, second night of the back-to-back, doesn't matter for him. He's going, 20-year-old kid, right? He's ready to play every damn night. 17 points, 8 boards, 2 dimes, 6 of 12 from the field, 5 of 7 from the free throw line, missed both threes that he took, didn't leave the game earlier. Looked like it was a little bit of a hammy tightness or something. They call it, I forgot what they actually called it. And he ends up coming back and playing the rest of the game. So he was okay. That's good news from Scotty Barnes. The last thing we need is for him to go down injured. So good news on Scotty Barnes' front. He played a great game again today. Defensively, yeah, there were a few times where he got lost and got in some foul trouble early on. But again, 17-8 for the young fella. Shot 50% from the field. I'll take that any day of the week from Scotty Barnes. Another great performance from him. But one performance that I got to talk about that was terrible. Chris Boucher. Last year we talked about it, and people agreed and disagreed with me. I'm not a big Chris Boucher guy. Look, there are times when he's great. Blocking shots, beautiful. But as we know, when he's trying to defend a three-point shot, I mean, they fake him one time, he's going flying by, or he's jumping right into the dude. And we talked about it even yesterday. You know, him taking three-pointers, he's just having no business shooting. When there's three guys right behind him, screw it! And fires it over top of him. It's like, Chris, he was 0 of 6 today. Didn't get a single point in the 8 minutes that he played. Was 0 of 3 from three-point range. Just with the liability out there, he was a minus 8 on the floor as well. He just hasn't been good at all in the first few games of the season. Now, obviously, that can turn around, and he can get hot at any point in time. But to start the year, Chris Boucher really hasn't given it for us. And we're going to have to see it. You need all hands on deck without Pascal in the lineup. You don't have Pascal for quite a bit longer, at least. So you're going to have to find a way to do without it for a while. And you need, like I said, all hands on deck. And Chris Boucher is an integral part with that. Because you look at Kem Birch, you look at Precious Achiuwa, they're not really three-point shooters. If Chris Boucher can knock down some shots from there, you know, he'll play more and he'll be more of a threat. It'll spread the floor for everybody else. And then, hey, good things happen. But the bench really didn't give you anything today. You know, not one person hit double figures. And, look, Precious had 10, OG with 23, Fred with 20, Trent had 12, Barnes with 17. Your whole starting unit was in double figures. But the bench gave you nothing. And that's why you only had 95 points today. And we talked about it in the preseason. We talked about it in the season preview. The question was, you know, what is the team going to give you offensively? Because that was a giant question mark. We know what you're going to get defensively, and that's been as advertised. 103 today, I believe 98 in game one, and 83 yesterday. I mean, they've been damn good defensively, but offensively, you know, 83 in game one, 95 today. They had the big breakout yesterday. You're going to get that once in a while, but you need to get that consistent offense to be a good team in this league. And again, this team is so young. Precious is 22, OG's 24, Fred's 27, like I said, the vet. Gary Trent's only 22, and Johnny Barnes is 20. Like, we're all expecting the world from these kids, but they're going out there, and they're doing everything they can. They're playing their hearts out, and that's all I can ask for them right now, all right? Shooting the basketball, like I said, here are the numbers to back my statement up. The Raptors shot 40% from the field, 30% from three-point range, and 70% from the free throw line. You look at the last game, they shot 42%, and that was the season high. So not a pretty start shooting the basketball in the first three games. Dallas only shot 42% from the field, 33% from three, and 72% from the line, which ain't pretty. But that much better than the Toronto Raptors today. It's unfortunate. Points off of turnovers, Raptors were plus 12. You know, and you look at the turnovers category, we only turned it over 9 times. A large portion of that, though, felt like it was in the third quarter. But again, they only turned it over 12 times. A very clean game on both sides for both teams. They just capitalized on the mistakes there in that quarter. I'm not saying all 9, you know, it felt like momentum shifted in that third quarter when the turnovers, you know, they had a few big ones, like back-to-back turnovers, which was terrible. All right, next game of the Toronto Raptors is on Monday as they host, I believe, DeMar DeRozan and the Chicago Bulls. 7:30 tip-off. They're looking to get back into the win column after tonight's tough loss. All right, you know what, guys? That is going to do it for this one. If you enjoyed the video and enjoy the game, take it. It was a very entertaining game, but whatever the case may be. Smack the like button to appreciate that. Hit the subscribe button if you guys haven't already. Comment down below thoughts on the video, thoughts on the game. What you like, what you not like from today's game today for the Toronto Raptors. Twitter's down below for myself. Follow up, send me a DM, do that great stuff, guys. The Instagram link is down below as well, so follow up there if you've not done so already. And I will talk to you guys Leafs Nation on Monday as they are in Carolina taking the Hurricanes. I don't know what team we're going to see. I'll talk to you guys post-game then, no matter what. And as for the Raptors, they take on the Chicago Bulls on Monday at Scotiabank Arena, looking for the first home win of the season. 7:30 tip-off there. Thank you guys so much for listening and watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. We'll talk to you guys then.